Hi everyone, this is Helen Cui from Virginia Tech. In this video nugget, I will introduce you an inductor geometry that can improve the space utilization significantly by making the flux uniform throughout the core volume. By doing this, the total thickness of a commercial inductor can be reduced by a factor of 2. The picture on the left shows a commercial inductor with enclosed winding geometry. As you can see, the inductor has a large area with zero energy, so the average energy density is relatively low in this kind of structure. And even if the winding is completely encapsulated by the core material, there is still a large area with blue color, which suggests very low flux density, and the red color suggests hot spots. Therefore, we found a chance for improvement if we can turn the red color and blue color all into green, or say to have constant flux distribution inside the core, then the magnetic material is fully utilized to store the energy. For the same inductance and resistance, the total volume can be reduced significantly. Based on the different position of the core and the winding, the inductors can be divided into two categories: enclosed core, such as torus, and enclosed winding, such as pod cores. The main objective of both types is to use the gap areas in the center or in the middle that have no energy stored. By making the flux uniform in the core, we can improve the space utilization while keeping the core away from saturation. And in this video nugget, I will focus on the enclosed winding geometry to show you how to use the gap area. If we take a look at the cross-section view of the inductor, the winding inside the core are grouped into several winding windows that carries a certain amount of ampere turns. The objective of the constant flux inductor design is to determine the radii and the ampere turns of each winding window so that the flux is controlled to drop from a maximum value Bmax to a minimum value alpha Bmax, where alpha is the uniformity factor. The higher alpha gives more uniform flux distribution. To briefly summarize the design procedure, first, we need to know the material's property, such as mu and Bmax, and also the uniformity factor. Then the radii of each winding window can be determined by Gauss' law. After the radii are calculated, the ampere turns carried by each winding window are determined by Ampere's law. Divided by the current rating, the ampere turns are approximated into several turns for each winding window. The solid model can be constructed in Maxwell to simulate the flux distribution. We can see that the flux inside the core is uniform with no flux crowding. The concept of constant flux inductor is validated by inductor prototypes made with micrometals plain core and LTCC ferrite material. The measured inductance and the resistance can match the simulation results with small error. Later, I will show you how to fabricate the inductor using the PCB routing machine. The core is made of micrometals powder iron material. The plain core was sliced into 1 mm thick core disks, and a core half of the constant flux inductor was routed on the core disk to the designed pattern. Before routing, the core disk was glued to a PCB substrate, and then the designed structure was imported into the routing machine. By setting up the routing speed and depth correctly, a cavity with 0.5 mm thickness would be routed on the disk using a 15mm end mill bit. After routing, the core was released from the substrate by soaking in acetone for half an hour. The winding was routed in a similar procedure on 0.5 mm thick copper sheet. Then the winding was inserted to a core half to make an inductor half. Two inductor halves were connected in the center by soldering. The prototype of the constant flux inductor has 2 times smaller thickness than a commercial product with similar inductance and resistance. That's all for this video. Thank you all. See you next time.